So I am here today because of this hair. So I ordered a steam curly. Now the last time I ordered steam curly, it was very beautiful at first, and then it started tangling very badly. So my hair lady, shout out to My Hair Plus, changed vendors, rightfully so, you know, this is what I was sent when I asked for it again. So the last time I ordered the steam curly, it was more of like a deep wave kind of texture, and this is more of a kinky texture, which I do, it's not that I don't like it, it's that I was not prepared for this type of maintenance. I've always kind of avoided kinky curly, honestly, just because like I said, it's very high maintenance. Not only that, my own hair texture is like I don't know if you see how perfect the blend is, but like this is what my hair texture is like. And I'm lazy. I don't even want to take care of my own texture hair. So like, imagine 30 inches of it. It's quite overwhelming. So, and then also, like, ain't nobody got time to be doing this every morning. I gotta be at work at 8 in the morning. So what I decided to do is I'm going to texturize this hair, because though I like the volume at the top, it's the ends that are really bothering me, because look at how stiff. No, I don't want that, right? And then also I haven't straightened it, but it just, I'm just not in love with this. So, right, what you're gonna need, wide tooth comb. If you have wider, better. And clips. Okay, and then a texturizer. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna section my hair off. So we'll probably do maybe 4 sections on each side. So first, we'll do it in half. Okay. Like, the hair is very pretty. I just was not ready for this type of maintenance, because I'm going to a wedding in like 2 weeks, and I just cannot be fussing with my hair this much every day. Like, my arms, please, my arms. So we're going to split this in two. And then split it into again. Right? So the reason why I'm sectioning it off this way is because I don't want to put the texturizer on every single strand of the hair. I really want to just focus on the ends. And then, like, I still want that voluminous look. I just want more of a deep wave. So I figure if I have some kinky, some deep wave, I might get a better desired look. So, right, and we're just gonna do some twists very loosely. It doesn't have to be perfect in any way. Four braids per section, right? So I'm gonna come back when my whole head is sectioned. Okay, we're back with our 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? 8 sections on each side, right? Safety is important. I'm just gonna read this really, really quickly. To 15, medium, 16 to 20. Okay, so it says, because this is a texturizer, it's not a relaxer. I don't know if I'm gonna leave it on for the whole time. Because obviously this is not my hair, so I can't feel it like burning my scalp or anything. So it's really just gonna be like, if the curls are looking the way that I want it to look, if that desired look happens before the full time, great. But if not, I'll just leave it on for the full 20 minutes. Gloves. Sometimes it has like a really strong smell. So I try not to like open it right in front of my face. So see, I just got a whiff. Okay, so what we're gonna do, and that's why I was like, don't do it too tight like this. We'll do the ends first. Right, don't do all of the ends and then like try to go back. No, we'll just start with the ends and then try to work our way up. This smells absolutely horrible. Absolutely horrible. All right, please don't be like me. Undo the twist. I guess the bigger section, and I'm gonna coat the entire, well, half the strand, because I like the volume. It's just, you know, the curl that I don't love. So we're really just doing this on the end, no roots, because we still want the volume. And then, oh man, I got something. And then I'm gonna just twist it again, just so like the other one that's not fully coated can be slightly coated with some texturizer, because we really want like a bunch of different curls. So the big thing about, this is raw Indian hair that I got, right? But I got it steam curly. And when you usually get a raw Indian bundle, all the curls are different. Right, there's small curls, little curls, you know, some kink, some texture, like it's just a bunch of different curls. When I got this, it was perfectly uniform, ringless, and I was like livid, because I haven't had hair like that in so long, and it just, I don't know, it just wasn't what I wanted. Right. So halfway. Right, spread that around. And I would just say, you know, try to keep it away from the face. I actually have a pair of goggles that I usually use when I do any type of chemical treatment on my head, right? Because most people be like, why didn't you do this while it was in bundle form? So I had co-washed it first, and when it was in bundle form, it was like a bit looser. It was only after I was done with the sewing that it like expanded like this, and I was like, oh, no, this is not gonna work. Right. So I'm gonna do just half of my head. I'll show you when I finish this half, because again, I don't want this video to be too long. And then hopefully the results give what they are supposed to get. Now, if you wanted to coat your whole head, right, and you're, you know, not like me who likes her curls to look a little different, who wants different looking curls, I would say maybe buy two of these, because this is 30 inches. This is 30, I have 30, 28, 26. So I don't think that one would be enough. I do want to point that out. Okay, so. And I'm gonna show you an example of what the look I wanted when I originally ordered this hair. So my hair lady, Miss Fox, of My Hair Plus, she had a client that had like this beautiful big poofy hairstyle, and when I saw it, I had ordered something completely different. Like, I wanted silky straight hair, and when I saw that, because she had installed individual micro links on the client, and then they had straightened it, so it was like silky straight. But then like a few weeks later, she wore it all big and like deep. It's like more of like a deep wave curly, and it was so beautiful. And I was like, this is exactly what I am looking for. And like I said, when I originally ordered it the first time, there was an issue with the vendor. They overprocessed the hair, and the back of my hair turned into a dreadlock. And you know, she was very, very gracious, and you know, sent me new bundles, because I've been buying hair from her for the last 5 years, and I don't do small orders. Like, the shortest hair I've ever ordered from her is 22 inches. I always do 30. Like, I'm always like, let me get 4 bundles of 30 always, like, because I ain't got no booty and my hair needs to cover it. So yeah, I don't know if it's me, but to me, this is not giving 30. That's also another thing that really irritated me about this hair. I was like, I paid a lot of money for this, and it's not giving what it's supposed to give, and it's definitely making me upset. So here we are. But okay, right? So this is what our sections are looking like, right? She kind of had like a salt and pepper kind of look. And okay, we're done. This is what we're looking like. So I'm just gonna put a little more on these ends, because that's the part that needs to be texturized for real, for real. Yeah, this is not giving 30 inches, like, even in the slightest. But we shall make do. And then also, like, there's a lot of volume. Anyways. Right? Sometimes bundles can be a hit or miss. This didn't work. It didn't work out this time, but it's okay. Okay. We'll do this so we don't get anything else. Okay, and then we're gonna use a clip. Like so, like that. And go on about your business for the next 20 minutes. Okay, let me go wash my hands before I rub my eyes and lose them. I'll be back when I wash my hair out. Okay, I'm back. I have a t-shirt on my head. That's very, very good for curly hair. Apparently, that is what they say. So this is the hair right now. Okay, look at it. Look at our ends. Yes, they might look a little dry, fried, and laid to the side, but we're going to moisturize them with Old Faithful Pink and this mousse. I love this one. Brawna Bros. I tried Lotta Body. No. But I would recommend Nairobi. Ugh. This and Nairobi, like, neck and neck. Like, I only get this one because they have it at Walmart. Nairobi, you know, is normally beauty supply stores. And you know, them people be trying to take all of our coins. So, I'm just gonna put a little bit on my hand and scrunch that up.
Now,
right, this hair is processed now, so it's technically not raw Indian anymore, but I still take heed to the raw Indian hair care, which is do not use a lot of heavy products. Like, I don't use any Cantu or anything. This is what I use because this is a moisturizing foam, right? And when you're dealing with curls, you just need moisture. Now, I actually got this texture because when I blow it out and I straighten it, it doesn't look like my hair is just sitting on top of it. It actually blends. And we know that that is the most important, you know, thing about hair extension. So, I'm gonna use a dime size. Literally this. Because this is this one, Luster's Pink, is a little more on the heavy side, and we don't want, you know, to make the hair too heavy. Now after I washed my hair out, I used the Aussie Moist Collection. So I use the Miracle shampoo and the Miracle conditioner, and now I'm gonna use the Miracle Moist Hydration Oil. So since I have moisturized my ends and they're still wet, I'm gonna use oil. Never put oil directly on dry hair because it's not going to lock in the moisture, unfortunately. Yes, it says a moisturizing oil, but you can't just toss it on top of the hair, unfortunately. And right, we have our thing, you know, moisturize our thing, our ends. Right, and I know the beauticians are like screaming internally because they're like, sections, honey. Yes, I know. So I'm here to give you sections, honey. Okay. Is this hair blown out is equivalent to a yaki texture. I don't like kinky straight because those ridges are very annoying to me. Like, it's just like, no matter how many times you press them out, they never go away. But this gives you that thick, like, you know when the curly girls straighten their hair and it's sleek and thick and you would never ever think in your life that they have curly hair? Yeah, that's what this hair gives. Yeah, for the natural girls, you know, that do like to heat style, and really like that nice silk press blend with their bundles, I definitely would recommend this texture. Especially, I am very, very happy with this result. Now, after this, I'm gonna show you the hair in like multiple different states. So I'll show it to you wet, and then I'll show it to you when I straighten it, and then also when I curl it. So we're almost done detangling this section. Now, please don't be like me. Don't ever start combing your hair in the middle of the shaft, right? You always start at the ends. You know, sometimes you get lazy. And I understand. It's just that if you buy long hair like me, you definitely want to try to retain that length. So you definitely want to be careful. Like, yanking like this will not get you far, unfortunately. And that's also another reason I had to texturize it, because when I moved, it was like moving in one piece. And I did not like that at all. I was like, I couldn't even say stiff wear because it was stiff everywhere. All right. Oh, another thing. Do never, 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 never take a razor like so and cut curly hair. Never. The reason why is curly hair is structured like this. A spiral. Oh, no. A corkscrew is the term we use in cosmetology school. So you have this corkscrew design. And blades are traditionally dull. It's to add texture, which is something that curly hair does not need. So the mechanism of a razor is up and down, up and down, up and down. And if you do that up and down with a spiral, what happens is it causes the spiral to it like breaks the form of the hair, and that one causes split ends, knots, and big frizz and tangle. So never, 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 never cut any layers into curly hair with a razor. Razor cutting is for straight hair to give it texture, right? Because straight hair can be very, very silky, right? But this already has texture. Therefore, you don't need a product that adds texture to the hair. You need a sharp scissor, sharp shear, right? And the reason why I'm saying sharp is because you don't want to do this glide down. You gotta cut it. You gotta hear the scissors. I'm just to avoid any frizz, because I made that mistake last time. My hair was straight, and this baby worked like a charm. Slid right through it, and that gave me the most perfect layers. But when it was time to wash it, I mean, the knots were like this. I was so upset. So, you know, now it wasn't just the fact that I cut it with that razor, but that definitely didn't help. The hair was already overprocessed, so those ends were gonna be shit anyways. But yeah, I definitely want to stress that to you, because I see sometimes, you know, people taking those razors to cut curly hair. You can do that on synthetic hair, right? Because it's going to get frizzy anyway. But if you're talking about hair that you spent good money on, and, you know, you ain't got the arm strength to be detangling it every day, trust me, please heed my warning. Do not cut any layers with a razor. Do not, do not, do not, do not. I said that for 2 minutes straight because I really, really, really want no one to waste their money on beautiful hair. Now, if you do that, all I'll say is go over it with scissors, right? But you're going to have to cut it shorter. And we want our inches, right? You didn't pay for 22. You paid for 28. So, you know, like, a perfect example, Alonzo. I've never seen him, I'm never seen him razor cutting anyone's layers. He always uses scissors, because sometimes you really don't know the actual texture of the hair that he's putting into those people's heads. So it's always best to go with scissors. Scissors are universal. Right, no heavy products, detangle from the ends, moisturize your ends, and no layering with razors. No going to sleep with wet hair. Even if it's braided, please, 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 just try. Try your best to get it as dry as possible. Not only that, you'll catch a cold. I caught a really, really bad cold the last time I went to sleep without my hair dry. And I really regretted it. Like, that cold lasted forever. Like, anyways, this is our look. If you have been struggling with some kinky, curly hair that you just cannot handle, or you were maybe sent the wrong thing and maybe they don't do exchanges or refunds, hey, go to the beauty supply store. You can get Luster's S-Curl, or you can get Luster's Short Looks, right? Same function, right? Product in the container. You just slap it on your hair. You don't have to mix nothing, you know? And you don't have to section it the way that I did. I still wanted some poofiness. I just didn't want all of it, right? You could put it on every single strand if you want. If you want more of like a, you know, Colombiana, Puerto Rican, Dominicana kind of look, you know? But yeah, so here it is. And yeah, so I'm out. Till next time.
Stiff wear.